So welcome back students for our today's next session for design of prestress concrete structures. So we'll discuss about losses in prestress concrete. Okay. So after the discussion over the deflections or the determination of deflections of beams in prestress concrete. So today we'll have the session or the next chapter, that is determination of losses in prestress concrete. So what is loss now? So first we'll see what is loss. So loss is nothing but what? It is a reduction in stresses. So reduction in stress. So reduction in stress matlab kya again? So we know that what is prestress concrete means. Suppose there is a one beam, okay, and which is having a tendon. Okay, concrete with a tendon. So how we are generating the stresses into the concrete? Through this tendon. Means there is a pre-stressing force at the ends. So that force will transfer the stresses into the concrete. That will transfer the stresses into the concrete. Okay. So that is the stress. That is the pre-stress. Okay. So when the tendon stretched and the released at the ends, it will transfer the force, and that force in turns develop the stresses into the concrete. That force develops the stresses into the concrete. So whatever the stresses has been transferred, okay, that will not be 100%. There may be lost in the stress, or there may be the reduction in the stress. So for example, a beam hai. So the initial pre-stress humne assume or we try to develop, that is 1000 Newton per mm square. So because of the pre-stressing force, concrete may at the initial stage kitna tha stress? 1000 Newton per mm square. But after some duration, maybe after 5 years 10 years, when we check there, so we got the stress is equal to 800 Newton per mm square. So kya hua yahan pe? We had designed for 1000 Newton per mm square, but later we got to know that there is a loss. Means we got the resultant or the final stress into the concrete is how much? 800 Newton per mm square. So iska meaning kya hai? There is a loss of 200 Newton per mm square. There is a loss of 200 Newton per mm square. So there are n number of factors or the n number of causes how the losses will get developed into the concrete. So we'll discuss one by one. Okay, so we'll have a small definition here. What is loss? The initial pre-stress in concrete undergoes a gradual reduction with time from the stage of transfer due to various cause. What? The initial pre-stress matlab hamara jo 1000 Newton per mm square tha in concrete undergoes gradual reduction. Jo 1000 tha wo gradual reduction hua with time from the stage of transfer due to various causes. So because of n number of causes, jo hamara stress 1000 tha wo 800 hua. Okay, so we'll discuss those clauses and we'll discuss the types of losses in prestress concrete. Okay, so there are different types of losses in prestress concrete. Okay, so those get bifurcated again based on what? Based on the system of prestressing. The types of losses get bifurcated based on what? Again, the system of prestressing. Okay, so there are two important systems in prestress concrete. One is pre-tensioning, one is post-tensioning. So in pre-tensioning we have the four types of losses. So consequence hai wo, first one is elastic deformation of concrete, second one is relaxation of steel, next one shrinkage of concrete, and next one is again creep of concrete. So there are four types of losses in pre-tensioning system. Post-tensioning mein kya hota hai? First these four, like elastic deformation of concrete, relaxation of steel, shrinkage of concrete, then creep of concrete, remain same in post-tensioning. Apart from these four, there are two addition in post-tensioning. Kaun sa hai? Loss due to friction, loss due to anchorage slip. What? Loss due to friction and loss due to anchorage slip. So I'll discuss one by one and I'll explain how the loss takes place, like the different types of losses in the prestress concrete. So we'll take first one is loss due to elastic deformation of concrete in pre-tensioning system. Okay, in pre-tensioning system. Okay, suppose hamare paas ek beam hai, okay, and a tendon. beam with a tendon, okay, in pre-tensioning it is, okay. So pre-tension mein kya hota hai, cable pehle stretch kiya jata hai, uske baad we used to place the concrete, after concrete reaching harder stage, we release the tendon from both the side. So that tendon we try to pressurize the concrete. That tendon will try to pressurize the concrete from both the side. So because of that, what will happen? The concrete gets shortened, or there is a shortening in the concrete. The concrete gets shortened or concrete gets deformed. So that is nothing but called elastic deformation of concrete. So there is a loss here. Correct? Because of deformation, there is a loss in the precious concrete. So what? See, delta is anything but what? Delta is anything but what? The deformation of concrete. So earlier it was L, so it will become L1. So earlier the length, suppose it was L, so later on it will become L1. So kya hua? Yahan pe loss hua ki nahi? So because of the what? The deformation of concrete, because of the elasticity of steel, try to go back and that will try to pressurize or compress this section. So kya hoga? Loss hoga. To usko kaun sa bolte hum? Due to elastic deformation of concrete. Okay. So this is regarding pre-tensioning. Next hai humara, okay. Now next is again what? Post-tensioning beams. Okay. Next question hai. Agar post-tension beam hai to. Okay. So we'll look out one by one here. Okay. So if number of cables or all cables pulled simultaneously, then there is a no loss of prestress. मतलब यहाँ पे क्या बोला है? If number of cables or all the cables, अगर आपके beam में तीन cable है suppose, 1, 2, 3, अगर सभी cables at a time stretch कर रहे हैं, all the cables are pulled simultaneously, then there is a no loss in the post tensioning system. But if cable are pulled one by one, look at here, it is important, cable are pulled one by one, then there is a loss of prestress. Then there is a loss of prestress. Agar if you stretch all the cables at a time, so there is no loss. But if you pull cable, agar first cable, second cable, third cable, if you pull one by one, then there is a loss. Okay. Now we have see here. For example, if cable one is pulled and ties, अगर एक cable one stretch किया जाता है, उसको tie किया जाता है, no loss. If cable 2 is pulled, then there is a loss in cable number 1. If we have two cables, for example, we have two cables, cable 1 pehle stretch kiya, usko tie kiya, then cable 2 stretch kiya, usko tie kiya, to cable 2 mein loss nahi hoga, there will be loss in cable number 1, because cable 2 will try to pressurize the concrete surrounding cable 1. To kya hoga? Cable 2 mein loss nahi hoga, cable 1 mein loss hoga. If cable 3 is pulled, then what will happen? There is a loss in cable 2 and 3. Then there is a loss in cable number 2 and 3. Samajh raha hai aapko? So simultaneously hai to kuch loss nahi hai. But if you stretch one by one, so there is a loss. Agar aap cable 1 pull karoge, no loss. Cable 2 pull karoge, to there is a loss in 1. Cable 3 pull karoge, then there is a loss in cable number 2 and cable number 1. Okay. So ultimately, how to calculate that loss? So here the calculation of loss is, how to calculate that loss? This is very important. So loss in prestress, how we can calculate? That is nothing but M into FC, Newton per mm square. So where M is equal to what? Modular ratio. M is equal to modular ratio. Where modular ratio is nothing but elasticity of steel divided by elasticity of concrete. Modulus of elasticity of steel divided by modulus of elasticity of concrete. So where ES you can choose 2 to 2.1 raised to 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. You can choose that. EC again we have from IS professing, that is 5700 square root of FCK. So these two will get. Next is how to get FC. This is very important. How to get FC. Abhi dekho, FC kaise milega aapko? How to get FC here? Now FC is nothing but stress in concrete at the level of steel. Stress in concrete at the level of steel. Okay. So here, now we have the concrete section. Okay. We have the concrete section of size rectangular. Okay. And we have the neutral axis. And we have the stress distribution diagram here. ये दोनों स्ट्रेस डिफ्यूजन डायग्राम है, दिस इज ड्यू टू बेंडिंग मोमेंट एंड दिस इज ड्यू टू प्रीस्ट्रेस। ओके, अभी बेंडिंग हुआ तो क्या होगा, बॉटम विल गेट टेंशन, टॉप विल गेट कॉम्प्रेशन, यू नो दैट बॉटम विल गेट टेंशन, टॉप कॉम्प्रेशन, एंड ड्यू टू प्रीस्ट्रेस बॉटम कॉम्प्रेशन, टॉप टेंशन, बिकॉज द प्रीस्ट्रेस द बीम विल बेंड अपवर्ड, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, टॉप विल गेट टेंशन, बॉटम विल गेट कॉम्प्रेशन। ओके, सो द बेसिक इक्वेशन फॉर दैट व्हाट, Fc is equal to the stress because of bending and the pre-stress is P by A, so that is direct stress, plus or minus P by Z plus or minus M by Z. Okay, so P by A direct stress plus or minus, what is I? What is Z? I by Y, then again Z I by Y. So here P by A direct stress, that will remain same, plus PE by I into E, so here not is Y now, here it is E. Why? There is a question here, because what they are given, stress in concrete at the level of steel, this is very important. So stress in concrete at the level of steel, matlab we have the steel here and this is our eccentricity. So what they are given, so earlier case we used to check, we used to take the YB for bottom fiber and YT for top fiber, but here what they ask, stress in concrete at the level of steel. Why they asked to check at the level of steel? Because when the tendon get released, so that time it will develop the stresses, or it try to pressurize the concrete at that particular section or that particular zone, so that time you have to take the stresses in the concrete at level of steel. So that's why you have to take, instead of Y you have to use E. Then at the level of steel, why it is plus here? Because due to pre-stress we have plus, and means bottom, at the location of steel means at the bottom, bottom matlab due to pre-stress we have plus and due to bending we have minus, so P by A plus P by I into E minus M by I into E. So instead of Y you have to replace E, that is a change, because stress is in concrete at the level of steel, that is very important. Okay, then the next is, I have given note also here, we need to consider the stresses at level of steel, so therefore the Y will become E, so that this you have to keep it in your mind. Okay, so this is regarding the elastic deformation of concrete in pre-stress, in pre-tension concrete and even post-tension concrete. So I'll just go on discussing the methods one by one. Okay, and we'll have the more discussion over the stresses, so you can easily solve the problems if you understood the formulas and how the loss takes place into the concrete. Okay, so we'll once again we'll meet in next session. So in next session we'll discuss the remaining losses in pre-stress concrete. Okay, so try to go back and try to check out, okay, in pre-tensioning how the elastic deformation takes place, in post-tensioning how the elastic deformation takes place. Okay, and this formula, what is the change in the formula because of stresses in concrete at the level of steel. Okay, and if you once understood this, we can have the solution of problems very easily. Okay, the basic change is what, because of change in the system of pre-stressing. Agar प्री टेंशन है तो क्या होगा, और अगर पोस्ट टेंशन है तो क्या होगा. प्री टेंशन में क्या होता है, देर इज बी लॉस. ओके, देर इज नो नीड ऑफ हैविंग द वन नंबर ऑफ केबल और टू नंबर ऑफ केबल, बट इन केस ऑफ पोस्ट टेंशनिंग, अगर इफ देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ केबल्स, सो यू हैव टू टेक केयर, सो दैट थिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, सो आई विल ट्राई टू फॉरवर्ड दिस कैम स्कैनर ऑफ दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन, सो हैव अ discussion over that, and you can discuss with your friends, and if you have any doubt you can come back to me. Okay, so we'll once again we'll meet in next session. Okay, thank you.